Hi and welcome to the Healthy Heroes Hop Into Holidays program. We're pleased to be offering you a fun and exclusive event brought to you by GMHBA and the Geelong Cats. My name is Tom Hawkins and today we're going to bring you some Zumba, yoga and mindfulness activities directly into your living room. So have your water bottle ready, your fruit snacks prepared and your shoelaces tied and get ready to move and have fun.
Welcome grade 3-4s, brothers, sisters, aunties, uncles, grandma and grandpa, and anyone else joining in today's Healthy Heroes Holiday Program. My name is Paul. I'm going to be taking you through today's warm-up to get your body ready for today's activities. First, we need a few things. We need some runners. Check. We need a drink bottle full of water. Check. And we need a safe spot to do all of our activities today. Check. Okay, let's get started. We're going to do 10 activities and we're going to do 10 repetitions for each one. Our first activity, running on the spot. Let's get our bodies moving for 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Our next activity we're going to do is star jumps. Star jumps coming out all the way up and then back down. We're going to do 10 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Our next activity, we're going to do side lunges. Coming out across and tapping the inside of our ankle and then moving across to the other side. We're going to do 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next, we're going to do high knees. Hands up above. And we're going to tap our knees with our hands. We're going to do 10 each leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next, we're going to do tail taps. Hands on your tails. We're going to bring our feet up to our tails. We're going to do 10 each leg. Are you ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next, we're going to do lunges. Lunges. One leg forward, coming down and back. Other leg, down and back. We're going to do 10 altogether, 5 each leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Because we are hopping into the holidays, we're going to do some hopping. 10 hops each leg. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now we're going to do 10 seconds of arabesque. Balancing, foot to the side, and balancing out. Can you hold that for 10 seconds? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, I got a bit wobbly there. Other leg, 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's 9, and our 10th and final one, probably the hardest, some touch-ups. A touch-up, we're going to do jump up, we're going to tuck our knees in the air, like that, okay. So we're going to do 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There we go, boys and girls. You should be huffing and puffing, having your body warmed up, just like I do, ready for today's activities. You might want to have a sip of your water and get ready for our first activity, Zumba. Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to our Healthy Heroes Holiday Program. We're very lucky to have Paula Kinsella here from the Geelong Gym. Thank you very much, Paula, for coming
in. Hello. Well, thank you for having me. I'm excited to do a bit of Zumba today.
Awesome. Great. So as Paula said, our first activity today is Zumba. So Paula, before we begin, would you like to tell us a little bit about yourself? So maybe your role here at Geelong's Gym, do you have any other hobbies and interests? And what football team do you go for?
Well, I've worked here at Geelong's Gym for a long time. I teach a lot of classes. Sometimes I teach Zumba. When I'm not working here at Geelong's Gym, I like to walk my dog. I've got a beautiful Brittany Spaniel called Bo, and I love to go to the theatre and see musicals.
Fantastic.
I love going and watching the musicals on the stage.
Yep, great. And hopefully we're back doing that very shortly.
Oh, and who do I bear it for?
That's right.
The Cats.
Go Cats.
Go Cats.
Fantastic. Right answer. Okay, now today you're going to take us through a Zumba routine. So for those that haven't heard of Zumba before, how would you describe it?
Well, Zumba started in South America, so it's Latin American rhythms. It's dance exercise. A lot of people say it's exercise in disguise because you're having so much fun, you don't realize how much exercise you're actually getting. You're working up a sweat, your heart, your lungs are pumping away, and you're working hard, but you're having fun. So I hope that's what you'll experience today.
Sounds fantastic. And that's what our healthy heroes like to do. Have fun while we're exercising. Sounds perfect. What advice would you have for someone that has no Zumba experience?
Well, it doesn't matter. You know, you don't have to get all the moves right. You can improvise, you can do your own individual moves. So long as you're moving, you're doing your body a world of good. So don't get too worried about whether or not your feet are exactly the same as my feet or your hands are in the same position as my hands. That really doesn't matter. Just move your body and you'll have fun.
Awesome. And if you were going to compare Zumba to a healthy meal, what meal would you compare it to? Is it going to be an Italian spaghetti and meatballs, or would it be an Asian noodle and vegetable inspired dish? What meal do you think it would be?
Well, it definitely wouldn't be a plate of Brussels sprouts.
Okay.
Even though that is healthy, I would say it would be like a big fresh fruit salad.
Sounds
strawberries,
right.
Bananas and grapes and pear and raspberries, all of that, because it's lots of colour and lots of excitement ahead.
Sounds lovely. Okay, so boys and girls, we hope you have a great session and enjoy.
All right, let's Zumba, shall we? All right, everybody, let's just start by marching in place. Clap your hands. Are you ready to wave your hands in the air? Go! And march. You can sing that bit. Hey-oh, hey-oh. Let me hear you. Hey-oh, hey-oh. Now reach. Reach across your body. And reach up high. Stretch your body. Step together and clap your hands. Open your arms. Hands up now. Reach, reach. March. Are you ready to wave those arms again? Are you wiggling your hips? Hey, wiggle, wiggle, side to side. All right, roll those arms. How fast can you roll them? Can you lift them and roll? Okay, leg curl behind. That's it. Kick it up right behind you. Now reach the arms. And reach your arms up. feet down. Let me see your hips. That's it. Side to side, bend your knees a little. Two counts. Two counts. Run. Wave those arms. Hey-o, hey-o. Are you getting warm? Oh, I am. Hey-o, hey-o. One more time. All right, clap your hands, step, clap. Come forward. Four, three, two, go back. Really travel to me and travel away. Walk across the floor. Walk, 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 say hey. Hey. Hey, that's it. Step it down. Hey. Hey. All right, we're going to bounce, team. Three, two, one. Three, two, one. Three, two, one. Now jump. Go. Three, two, one. Easy walk. Easy walk. Go low, go high, go low, come away. Watch my feet. One, two, three. One, two, three. We call this a pony step. Get on your pony. Pony ride. Okay, step and tuck. Should we do that again? We're going to take it for a walk across the floor. Go. One, two, three. Say hey. Say hey. Use those lungs. Hey. 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 Are you ready to bounce? Let's bounce. Go. Three, two, one. And jump. Walk. Hold it here. Little pony step now. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two. Okay, lean in. Go down, down, up, up. Nice and slow to begin. Now go. Three, two, one. Lift up. See if you can have your knees over your toes. Three, two, one. One more time. Knee comes up. Here we go. Eight, seven. Pull those arms down strong. Switch. Switch again, now give me a knee and punch, knee and punch. Keep going, it's a bit tricky, knee and punch. Shall we swap sides, double knee, knee and punch. Punch hard, that's it, punch. One more knee, ready for squats, go slow. Get your bottom right down to the back of the knees if you can. Now hold it down for three, two, one. Can you keep your heels on the ground when you squat? 1, 2, 3. One more time. Turn your body to the side and tap that foot in. In and out. Bring that knee up. Switch sides, tap. Now bring the knee up, up. Hold it right here. We go down, two, up, two, down, two. Turn other leg, lunge, down, two. How's your balance? Good. Good, down, two, up, two. How are your squats? You're getting low. One more here. Take it down. Three counts to go. Three, two, one. Three, two, one. Okay, keep your knees bent a little bit and just punch in front of your body. Punch, punch, punch. Feel that rotation through your body. Take now. Oh, you can feel your waist working, your tummy muscles. Feel it? Can we finish with a tricky one? Have a turn. See how you go. Go knee down, down, knee down, down, knee down, down. Oh, it is a bit tricky. Just do your best. Oh, well done, everyone. All right, one more high-energy song, and then we're going to do some stretching together, okay? We just step, 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 step. Now wind your hips around like that. Yeah, step side. I'm Osansa, Osansa, Osansa faithfully. Again. Jump backwards, team. 4, 3, 2, 1, come to me. Jump away. Run. Jump. Run. I'm looking at you, hey. Here, one, two, one, two, shuffle. Other leg. Shuffle. Do it again. Hands on hips, side feet up. Two steps.
One hand if you're drinking, two hands in the air if you're ready for the drinking. In the party we sinking. Mathematical is a jam. What you drinking?
You want to wave your hands? Let me see you wave your hands. Can't decide to wave your hands. It's all to start, just wave your hands.
From the top, here we go. Stop. Stop. And I don't give up. Wind it up.
When the music's on me, I'll be ready. when the big chocks come in. When the big chocks come in, I'll be ready.
Your last take chance to jump and run. Lastly, come on. One more. What you're doing, and do this. You jump, 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 Are you breathing heavy? Your heart and lungs are working really hard to get all that blood around your body right now. I think we are ready. If I can find... I'm looking for a particular song to cool us down, team. Sway your hips. I hope you had fun. I hope you are sweating a little bit like me. Arms up, arms up. Let your heart rate come down a little bit. We are going to stretch. Put your toe back. Yeah, feel that flexion. Feel that up the back of your leg. Your hamstrings stretching. Change leg. Moving her back. Doesn't that feel good? Up we come. See if you can balance. Bring your foot into your hand. How's your balance? Can you pull that knee back? Change side. Steady and balance. Pull that heel into your bottom. Good work. Now over to one side. Stretch, feel that lengthening through the side of your body. Can you put your hands down to the floor there? And we'll creep across to the other side. Well done. Push your knee out wide. Now lay the elbow down, up and over. Roll the body up, roll up, roll your shoulders back. Can you reach your hand right behind your back and open up your chest like this? Now I want you to wiggle, 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 shake it off, shake it off. Give yourselves a big clap because you were tremendous. I hope you enjoyed doing Zumba with me, and I'll see you next time. Have a great day.
Boys and girls, I hope you had a great time doing Zumba. And now we've got Natasha here from Geelong's Gym with us to take us through some yoga and mindfulness. Now, before we begin, Natasha, I'd love to know a little bit more about yourself. What do you do when you're not teaching yoga?
When I'm not teaching yoga, I am a personal trainer. I spend a lot of time helping other people work out, things like that. I love to go for a bike ride. That's my favourite activity. Outside of yoga.
Awesome. Yeah. It sounds like you like to keep nice and active, and that's
yes.
One of the things our healthy heroes love to do.
Yeah.
What's your favourite snack to do to help give your body energy after you've been exercising?
After exercise, I like to actually have a piece of fruit, just something small. Sometimes it's like half an apple or something like that, maybe not even whole.
Yeah.
But just a nice, healthy piece of fruit. I particularly love berries. That's my favourite.
Yep, love it. And All the colours of the rainbow as well.
All the colours, well.
And
yeah.
No wrapping and ready to go.
That's right.
Awesome. And... you're going to take us through some yoga today.
That's
so
right, yeah.
How does yoga and mindfulness help keep our bodies and minds fit and healthy?
Yoga is really great for both of those things because it does get our bodies moving, and it's a gentle practice, so you get to work at your level, not at the person or someone next to you, or maybe even, you know, you see someone on a video. and they look amazing and you think, oh, I can't do that. It doesn't matter. You get to work at your level. And the other thing about it is that it actually is really calming for the mind. So we spend a lot of our times a little bit stressed about, you know, schoolwork or driving or parents at work and all of those kinds of things that our minds are thinking of. It just brings us back down. We're able to concentrate. We're able to breathe and just be with our bodies and just focus for a change. It's really good.
That sounds really important as well with everything that's going on, just to take that time to reset.
That's right.
Now, for someone who has never done any sort of yoga or mindfulness practice before, what advice would you give them?
So my advice is just start where you are and do what you can. If you find anything a little bit too challenging, for example, I'm going to be down on my hands and knees a lot today. You could do this on the bed, on the couch, anywhere where you need to find it a little bit more comfortable. You could even like kneel on the couch and put your hands on the handrest or something like that. You could just find a position that's a bit more comfortable for you and still do all of these moves.
Right, so just working within your limitations.
That's
awesome,
right.
Thank
yeah.
you. And lastly, I'd love to know, where is the craziest place you've ever done yoga?
I actually did my yoga teacher training in India. So the craziest place I've done it was on a big rock on the banks of the River Ganges.
Fantastic. All right. With that, boys and girls, enjoy our mindfulness and yoga session. Thank you.
Thank you. I just want you to come into a comfortable sitting position. You might not find sitting on your knees comfortable, but if you do, feel free to go there. You might not find sitting cross-legged comfortable. You might want to sit in a chair. That's okay. Just find a position where you're comfy. And the first thing that we're going to focus on is our breathing. The breathing is the most important thing to connect our bodies to our mind and to just make us feel a little bit better. So what I want you to do is just close your eyes, lengthen up through the spine. So you're sitting really tall, and then just relax through the spine a little bit. And then take a nice breath in, breathing in for the count of four. So inhale, one, two, three, four, and then exhale, four, three, two, one. Let's do that again. Inhale, one, two, three, four, and exhale, four, three, two, one. Let's do that for three more breaths. Inhale, one, two, three, four, and exhale, four, three, two, one. Inhale, one, two, three, four, and exhale, four, three, two, one. One more time. Inhale, one, two, three, four, exhale, four, three, two, one. And then just breathe normally and open your eyes. So that exercise that I've just taught you is really great to do at any time of the day. Sometimes when we're a little bit drowsy first thing in the morning, if you do that breathing practice, you'll find you're a lot more awake. And in the reverse too, if you find you're a little bit too wound up to go back to sleep, or if you've woken up in the middle of the night, or perhaps it's towards the end of the day and you've spent a lot of time on your screens and things like that, doing that breathing exercise will help calm you down. So it's a really good practice, and it actually works in so many ways through your body. Cool. So we're going to take that breathing practice and we're going to put it into a little bit of stretching, a little bit of movement. So the first thing I want you to do is come to your hands and knees and tuck your toes under. This is called rock pose. You might need to tuck your little toe under here on each side. If you find this really hard to do, you can do this sitting in a chair and just do one foot at a time. Just put the foot behind you and just tuck the toes under. So you're starting to get a little bit of a stretch through the sole here. So if you're comfortable, then you come up and you sit nice and tall. And let's take our rock pose and breathe, inhaling, 1, 2, 3, 4, exhaling, 4, 3, 2, 1, inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, exhale, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's just do one more. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4, exhale, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then just bring your weight forward and we'll give our toes a little shake, maybe even a little clap of the feet behind you. And we're going to stretch it the other way now. So again, if you're seated, just tuck your toes so that you're getting a stretch down the front of the ankle here. So you might find comfortable just sitting here. That might be enough. You might be able to bring your weight back. You might be able to lift your knees off. I'm not going to do that right now because I don't think that feels good for me. And it's really important that you listen to your body and I'll listen to mine. So let's take the breath just for two breaths here. Breathing in. 1, 2, 3, 4. Breathing out. 4, 3, 2, 1. One more time. Breathing in. 2, 3, 4. Exhale. 4, 3, 2, 1. And then coming weight forward again. Giving those feet a bit of a slap. Shaking out through the feet. And then we'll do this toe tuck, this rock pose, one more time. Rock pose is a really good one, especially if there's anyone that gets things like plantar fasciitis and things like that. It can be really good for that. You also might find it really too strong. So you need to listen to your body and you only go to the point where you feel you can maintain that position. If it does get too much, by all means, bring yourself forward, come out of it. But you're looking at probably about an 80% stretch. You don't want a full stretch for this one. So let's do three more breaths here. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 4, 3, 2, 1. One more time. Inhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, and then just come forward, give it a bit of a shake out. I love the feeling of that blood flow just coming back. Feels good. Okay, we're going to do a little bit of a wrist stretch now. So if you, like me, have spent a bit more time lately seated, what happens is that we find we tend to have our hands like this a lot, whether we're writing, whether we're typing, whether we're holding phones. We're in this what they call flex position. We want to extend back the other way, so we'll get a nice stretch through the forearms. So coming onto your hands and knees, and just make sure you rotate the hands back towards you. You may not get as far back as I do, and that's okay. You might be out to the side, and that might be enough. But you're just coming to the point where you can put a little bit of weight through the palms, through the fingertips. And you might, if you are flexible enough, come back and forwards. So the other thing that's going to make a real difference is what time of day you're doing these stretches. So I know for myself, when I did this actual stretch this morning, and I did, it was really hard. It was really tight. It was quite sore. But now that I'm a bit warmer and I've been exercising right before coming in here today, it's quite a lot loosened off. So it's going to depend what time of day, what else you've been doing as to how flexible you are. So We're just getting this gentle stretch through our forearm here, on the inside of the wrist, up to the elbow. And then if we just bring our weight off and give it a shake out, I'll turn front on to you, just shake it down. If you prefer, you can stand up. I don't mind doing this kneeling. It feels quite comfortable for me, but if it doesn't for you, by all means, please stand up. And it feels good again just to let that blood flow. So the next thing we're going to do is work through our spine, which is great because, again, slouching a lot probably, sitting in those chairs, maybe sitting more than normal instead of getting out and about. So coming again to your hands and your knees, I just want you to think about keeping your hands underneath your shoulders. Or if you could prefer, you can do this standing. It is possible to do this standing and just put your hands on a table or a couch or something like that. All right, so what you're going to do is take a nice deep breath in, and then as you exhale, you're going to arch your back like a cat. So you push into the ground, your head drops down, your tailbone drops down. And then as you inhale, you do the opposite. So you let your spine drop down, but your head and your tailbone lift, and they call this cow. Let's do that again. So exhale into your cat. And inhale into your cow. And if you want to have a little bit of fun with it, especially because you're probably at home while you're doing this, you can just meow into your cat. And if you want to, you can moo into your cow, and I don't mind. Sometimes it's fun just to let out those noises. It's good for our body. So what is actually happening here? You've got a nerve in your body called the vagus nerve, and it's responsible for things like your heart rate, and it's responsible for things like your nervous system. So you've probably heard about fight or flight or rest and digest. So these kind of movements and the noises that you make when you do like cat or cow noise, things like that, or horse lip like that, things like that, it actually vibrates on that nerve and it makes you feel relaxed. Isn't that amazing? Body is really amazing. Okay, let's do one more of these. And then just come to a neutral spine. So neutral is somewhere in the middle between those two points where you've been. So I'm just going to show you side on here with this next one. It's essentially the same position, but you're going to bring your shoulder and your hip towards each other one side, and then you go back to neutral. And then you do the other side. So you exhale to the side and you inhale to the center. You might like to sigh as you go to the side and then breathe in and sigh to the other side. And breathe in. So if you want to keep doing the sigh, it's nice to just let it all go. Let's do one more on each side, guys. Okay, and then coming to sitting, we'll do a little bit of a hip opener here. So this is a nice one. Especially if you're the kind of person where you feel you have tight hips, your knees are maybe up here, you probably need to do it even more than everyone else. So it's a really good one for you to give a go. If you find that you struggle with your lower back, I know some of the parents out there might find that, please just put your hands behind you and sit up really tall to take the pressure off your back, and then just let gravity let your knees drop down or you can use a little bit of inner thigh muscle to help them drop down. If you feel comfortable, you can bring your hands to your feet and just try and push the knees down with your elbows. If you're the kind of person that can get the knees to the floor, feel free to fold forward. I won't join you. Actually, speaking of India, when I did my yoga teacher training, my teacher came and he stood on my knees and they went down to the floor, but I wouldn't recommend that you try that. It was pretty full on. Sometimes I think it's better to just allow time to let your body open than to force it. Okay, and then we'll take this into what they call windscreen wipers. So coming out of that, dropping your knees down to one side and then up and over to the other side. Try to keep your hips down. They may not stay down, but we just allow our hips to open in whatever way they can. And just like with anything, the more you practice these things, the more your body improves, the more mobility you'll have through those joints. And that's really what we're looking for here. Okay, so we're going to do one more thing. All right, come over to your hands and knees again. So this you can also do with your hands on a chair standing if you prefer. We're going to do what's called the down dog position, and this is a good one. So you just bring your hands underneath your shoulders, tuck your toes behind you, lift your hips high, and push your hips backwards. And I want you to try and hold this position with our breath. We're just going to stay here for a little bit longer. Breathing in, one, two, three, four. Breathing out, four, three, two, one. Two more breaths. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Exhale, four, three, two, one. One more time. Inhale, one, two, three, four. Exhale, four, three, two, one. And then come on down. And just find a comfy sitting position. So that's it, guys. I hope you really enjoyed just having a little stretch out with me. And don't forget that breathing technique. As I said, it's really great. If you're a bit tired, you can wake up. If you want to go to sleep, it will actually help you calm down and go to sleep as well. So thank you for having me.
Thanks for joining us today for our Healthy Heroes Hop Into the Holidays program, brought to you by GMHBA and the Geelong Cats. We have all our Healthy Heroes resources available for you to use and download. You can find them at our Geelong Cats website in the community area. You'll also find the links in our comments section below. For your chance to win one of 10 prizes, all you need to do is send in a picture of yourself recreating one of our Healthy Heroes recipes. My favourite is the Joel and Tom rice cake faces. We hope that this has helped bring some fun and activity into your day. Take care, stay healthy, and go Cats. Bye.